isn't too loud for me, believe it or not. This is a test of the microphone, which I have attached into my new GoPro media mount. See if we can hear sound, and then I can continue making videos with hopefully better quality sound. Woo! All right, guys, mic test was successful. Wow, this thing even has, wow, it has a microphone. You can't see it. On the LCD I'm looking at in the back, it has a mic meter. A meter that's bouncing up and down. I've never seen that before because it senses the external mic. That's sick. Anyway, we're talking about spoiler. All right. I have something coming that I'm sure will already be known when this video comes out, but I'm going to go ahead and work on removing this puppy very carefully and to be prepared and, you know, work on the cleanup and preparing it. And also, I kind of want to see what it looks like bone sedan for a while. Probably just looks just like an A3 or something. I don't know. All right. So first off, let's get the heat. First off, you always go with heat. It's kind of, there's so many videos out of the same thing, and you know, and 98% of everybody says the same thing, but people still make videos, right? Warm up the puppy a little bit. I mean, once I get one side, I pretty much just work it all the way off. I'm not using any tools yet. I'm just kind of getting a feel for it, seeing how stiff it might be. It's moving good. This side's getting real, real good. Oh yeah. A tool might help with that. Let's check it out. Get rid of the heavy tools. We'll use something in here. Alright, I'll put down a rag before you guys yell at me. I mean, my trunk's already scratched anyway. Alright. We get, no, that's a little bit rough there. I need something real fine, real, oh yeah, that's pretty easy. That's real easy. Okay. See, that's too bumpy. That's horrible. I'm going to sand it, of course. I mean, fix it, but yeah, I don't want to put a big jagged one in there. Not that plastic is softer than, you know, this, but man, yeah, I don't want to break it. I'm gonna do heat. Let me get somewhere on this. Let me heat up a bunch, and then we'll be back to check in. It's not like bending or molding, which is good. You know, it isn't keeping it. I'm not wrecking it. It would still sit perfect. Look at that by itself. It could still sit perfectly flat. The only thing is, you know, if I crack it, I'm done. I guess more patience. I can get it. Got to keep applying heat. I'm not going to rush it for the video. Crack it right in front of you and be a total idiot. So let me apply more heat. Take my time. And when I'm just about done, we'll hop back in.
That is a
tight spot right there. Now we should have it. I already had the edge done, man. I must be getting close. Here it comes. Here it comes. I didn't damage it. I didn't even put one chip in it anywhere. Sick. That is a beautiful spoiler. The cool thing is, I can have a change of mind if I want, and I just peel this off, you know, clean it up, put on fresh glue, whatever. I could always get this back. I mean, I kind of expected and hoped that it was that easy to do, and it was. So now, here's what we got going. Let me turn off this dumb top light. It's actually making it worse. All right, so we have right here all this adhesive. Now I am gonna think about a little more and be careful getting off this adhesive. I'm even gonna tape up on this side of the adhesive to first off avoid as much marring as possible, and then, you know, really just figure out the best way to do it without, you know, grinding it to all hell here. Super, way easier than that frickin' lower badge thing we did, that Audi rings. This is coming off way, way easier. Awesome. This is just mostly dirt that I'm gonna clean later. Some detailer. First off, just to pick up some of the dust, you know, without scrubbing. So get it nice and lubed up and really dab it just to kind of pick up the excess dust. So anything you do have to put some effort into, you're not going to be spreading it the entire thing just over and over and over. So I'll just do a very sort of like a dab. Picks up all the crumbs. The cool thing, in the middle of the spoiler, between the tape, there was no dust. So that means it was 100% freaking seal. It was really good. Oops, I shouldn't go back and forth like that. I mean, I'm not keeping it cherry, don't worry. This isn't a show car, all right? It's just a car I'm just working on. So I'm getting lazy. Now I'm gonna spray it on the spoiler. It actually works better. All right, got that all picked up. Of course, we're gonna polish, of course, even now. There's some adhesive I gotta work on. We're gonna polish it and then await the new spoiler. So yeah, I'll keep working on that a little bit. We're almost there, it's almost ready. All right, let's do a little bit of polish. It's still all taped off except for this band that I'm gonna go a little bit heavy on just cause it is pretty scratched. And then I'll do the ultra cut probably on the whole trunk, because you know I have... Oops, did the camera fall a little bit? Yes, it did. There. Let me double check in this back view. Oh, that's better right there. All right. Screw it. I don't want it splattering. It's such a small, thin spot that I guess it's kind of hard. Let's do, I don't know, a 5. Slow clutch start on the Bigfoot, detailing 15 rupees. Rupees. Tape marks and stuff here and there. You can see stuff right there. Little things, but yeah, it's looking, it's getting pretty good. I actually saw, I saw some deep scratches come out just about everywhere. Some scratches that have even been there before I touched it. The trunk overall was kind of a not the best maintained spot. All right. I just got to get out this last couple bits of adhesive because I don't want to polish it, you know, with the adhesive in there. And probably really just does pick up, feels like it picks up some of that last gritty stuff, like maybe not all of it, but it is helping a little bit. I can't quite feel that bump under my fingers, just a little bit, like right here there's a real sticky one. Probably just flood it with freaking alcohol and get rid of it. I know I'm using my fingernail, of course I shouldn't be doing that. Whatever. Polish it up. All right. I'm satisfied with the clay bar. It's about as good as it could be, especially on the frickin' edge. Still clean. Probably didn't even need it. Splash and wet from the glass because that's a pain in the ass. Oh, just down here. Pain in the ass to get off later once it dries. All right, got my shrapnel. I get my edges. They got a little shrapnel. Get all those whites polished specks out. All right, let's come in for a close set. All right. bad, pretty good. Now there is, you might not be able to see it on the screen, or you might, ooh, I just got that. Oh my God. I was just literally saying there's one bit of adhesive I just couldn't get, and I just caught it with my finger and got it. But now there is like shades or like, you know, hologram stuff that this ultra finished, no, what did I do? What did I just use? Ultra cut compound is what I used. I wanted something nice because this trunk has been pretty, not in the best shape. So I really wanted to give it kind of a deeper overhaul, you know, rather than just half-ass it, you know. I wanted to really give it a good scrub. It's looking pretty dang incredible, actually. Let's be honest. And I haven't even done the ultra polish yet. Look at that so far. Yeah, we can't tell how funny that, I guess it just looks like an A3. A very badass A3. Like it'll just, boring but sleeper-like, you know? Until someone sees the badge, of course, which is stupid, so yeah, never mind. I'm gonna now go from ultra cut up to ultra finish cut, and, all right, now we're gonna go with some ultra finish. A little bit just to finish up, try and get that extra little bit of gleam on. Watching me polish? All right, whatever floats your boat. No, I'm just kidding, I appreciate it. All right, yeah, you got enough shot, enough glare on that. Let's freaking polish this, see what you can see. See if you can see it happening as I get closer to you, I don't know. Or if it's kind of backwards and your camera should be on this side to see the clean slate, I don't know. Here we go, your special spot. Woo! Damn. Wow. That is it, guys. Wow. Let's throw a little coat of wax on that for good measure. I turned the speed down a little kind of late, but you know, I don't need the high speed just for waxing. Just for polishing, you know, you need your high speed. Waxing, you're just really trying to be gentle, so I just turn off all that. Bring it down to a 2. Yeah, there's some, always been some window stains. Take off the final polish or sealant. Wow. I don't even want to put a finger on it. It's too good. Done with the spoilerless S3. A little bit boring, huh? A little bit not cool. It'd be a lot cooler if you did. Alright. Hey man, got a joint. Alright. Well, I can't start obsessing on every little spot in the car now. What matters is that the trunk is 100%. It is ready for its new spoiler. You will have to wait and see what we got coming on that. But obviously there was a reason I took this off right now. So I haven't even told my Titus channel followers what's on the way. It's a surprise. And it should come in a couple days. And then you'll find out. If you stayed here till the end, thank you. Subscribe and like.